Stirling is extremely important, and you go battle after battle. You have our great hero, William Wallace, Braveheart, made famous by the film by Mel Gibson. Stirling Bridge in September 1297, where he destroyed a huge army. A year later, at the first battle of Falkirk, the king himself, Edward I, Boo, came up with a huge army, and the Scots under William Wallace was badly defeated. William Wallace was captured later and executed. He was hung, drawn and quartered brutally. And then we had our second great hero, Robert the Bruce. Now, he killed a man, a claimant for the throne, Red Comyn, in 1306. A very bad thing to do, to kill somebody in a church. He ran to, with Bishop Wishaw, or one of the bishops, to Perth, and was crowned himself king in 1306 on the ancient Stone of Destiny at Scone Palace, believed to be Jacob's pillar from the Bible. For 8 years he got lost battle after battle. He won a great victory on the 24th of June 1314 at Bannockburn. And even today, if the English beat us at football or any sport, we say, remember Bannockburn. This was a huge victory against the great army under, this time, Edward II. My ancestor, on one side of the family, I'm a Burnett. Sir William Burnett and his men fought extremely bravely. We were given a hunting horn. This is a horn from a Highland cow, and you use it as a hunting horn, so if you see a deer, you blow it to tell the other hunters. We blocked it up and used it as a drinking vessel. Much later on, we will visit some of the things, and if you have time, after the castle, please go into that church. It's extremely historic. James the Sixth of Scotland, who was a monster, he was crowned there when he was 13 months old. He was only a baby, and he's crowned King of Scotland. 36 years later, he's crowned King of James the First of England and Scotland. This is the union of the crowns, a black day in Scottish history. We go close towards England. England, boo. Anyway, well, sayonara! Sayonara!
まあ、観光地としてはグラスゴーとかエディンバラがやはりメインで、スターリングに来るっていう人はなかなかいないと思うんですけども、まあ、スコットランドの歴史を語る上ではもう欠かせない場所であり、まあ、実際に昔スターリングを取る者がスコットランドを取ると言われたぐらい、まあ、占領をするしようとするイギリスにとっても要所であり、守るスコットランド側にとってもまさに重要な拠点だった場所、それがスターリングなんですね。まあなのでスターリングを落とすために、まあスコットランド王がスターリング城にいたというのもあるんですけども、ここを落とすためにたくさんの戦いが行われたわけですし、あのスコットランドの英雄ウォレスも、イギリス、イングランドを打ち破る大きな戦いをしたのもここスターリング、まあね、スコットランドの魂があるようなそんな場所じゃないでしょうかね。まあ本当に素朴でなんか派手なものがあるわけでもないですし、スターリング城も、まあ、エディンバラ城と比べたら、まあ、全然小さいですし、そんな有名でもないですけど、まあ歴史のストーリーが違うっていうところですかね。熱くね、スコットランドの歴史についてスコットランドの魂を持ったおじいさんががっつり話してくれましたけどね、あの語り、私の前にも他の観光客にがっつりねしてましたねすごい、まさにスコットランド魂ですね。
Thank you.